Hi friends, welcome to Virtual Lab of Chemistry. Today we are going to do estimation of alkalinity of water sample. This is Dr. S. Rekha, Associate Professor, RMD Engineering College, Chennai. So let us get into the topic. Alkalinity of water is caused by basically anions like hydroxide, carbonates and bicarbonates. If these ions are present, then water is having a pH greater than 7. Then the water is said to be alkaline in nature. If all the three ions are present, then naturally what happens, hydroxides and bicarbonate react together to form carbonate. They cause alkalinity, but they cause in the form of carbonate, and water is also formed in the process. So basically, if water is alkaline in nature, all the three ions cannot be present because they are reactive in nature. Hydroxide and bicarbonate are reactive in nature, hence either of the two ions are hydroxide or carbonate or bicarbonate, individual ion may be responsible for the cause of alkalinity of water. To identify the quantity as well as the what is the ion which is present in water, we carry out this experiment with two indicators called as phenolphthalein indicator and methyl orange indicator. Phenolphthalein indicator is used to neutralize the strong base, and methyl orange indicator is used to neutralize the whole strong base as well as weak base. So methyl orange indicator indicates the total alkalinity value. Knowing the value of P and M, we can find out what is the ion present and what is their quantity in water. Let us see the simple procedure of the experiment. Iteration 1, burette solution, HCl solution, pipette solution, 20 ml of sodium carbonate solution, which is a standard solution, indicator, 2 drops of methyl orange, endpoint, color changes from yellow to orange, let the HCl consumed be V1 ml. Iteration 2, burette solution is same, HCl solution, pipette solution is 20 ml of sample hard water, for which alkalinity is to be estimated. Indicator, here we use two indicator, 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator and 2 drops of methyl orange indicator. For phenolphthalein indicator, endpoint is disappearance of pink color, and for methyl orange indicator, the endpoint is color changes from yellow to orange, and let the value be recorded as PML and MML. P stands for phenolphthalein, M stands for methyl orange, and equivalent weight of calcium carbonate is 50. Chemicals required: sample water, standard sodium carbonate solution, hydrochloric acid, phenolphthalein indicator, methyl orange indicator. Apparatus required: conical flask, pipette, burette, wash bottle. Fill the burette with HCl solution and fill the nozzle and adjust to zero mark without bubbles. Now let us see titration 1. Pipette out 20 ml of standard Na2CO3 solution, that is sodium carbonate solution, and add to the conical flask. Now to this solution, add indicator. So what is the indicator here for titration 1? Is methyl orange. So add methyl orange indicator. So the solution turns to yellow. Now let us do the titration. So burette is filled with HCl solution, and upon titrating with the conical flask solution, so yellow color slowly turns to orange in color. So the end point is color changes from yellow to orange. Let us note down the HCl consumed as VML. To get the simulated value, click the button. Upon clicking the button, you get the value as HCl consumed is V is equal to 19.6 ml.
Enter the value in the tabular column as shown in the figure. What is the summary of titration 1? So we have taken sodium carbonate solution. To that we have added methyl orange indicator. Upon adding methyl orange indicator, we get solution turning yellow. And to this, titrating with HCl solution, we get orange color. That is your end point. Now let us do titration 2. So pipette out 20 ml of sample water into the conical flask. To this solution, add the phenolphthalein indicator. So upon adding phenolphthalein indicator, color changes to pink in color. Okay, now let us do titration.
Yes, students, let us do the titration. So in the butyrate solution, we have HCl. So conical flask, we have added phenolphthalein indicator, and let us titrate. See, upon titration, color changes to colorless. Okay, pink color disappears, and that is your end point. Okay. So let us note down HCl consumed as P end point. Okay. And let us simulate and get the values for 5 different sample water. Okay. So batch 1 students, you have been given with sample A water. So please make a note. I will simulate and get you the value. Yes. So sample A, phenolphthalein endpoint is 13.4 ml. Please make a note, batch 1 students. Okay. So let me simulate once again for batch 2 students. Yeah, batch 2 students, upon simulation, sample B, phenolphthalein endpoint is 7.1 ml. Please make a note. So let me simulate once again for sample C. Yeah, on simulating, I have got sample C, phenolphthalein endpoint as 13.1 ml. Okay. Batch 3 students, please make a note. Yes. Batch 4 students, sample D, phenolphthalein endpoint is 7.3 ml. Please make a note of it. Let me simulate the last sample and get the value. Yeah, batch 5, sample E, phenolphthalein endpoint is 12.9 ml. Okay. So please make a note of it, all the 5 samples. Now what we have to do, we have to continue the titration by adding methyl orange indicator. So to this solution, add methyl orange indicator. Yes, solution turns to yellow in color. So continue the second titration. Half reacted HCl solution. With that, we continue the titration. Yes, upon titrating it, the yellow color solution turns orange. Yeah, endpoint is color changes from yellow to orange. So let us note down the HCl consumed as M endpoint, methyl orange endpoint. And let us simulate and get the value. Let us click the simulate button and get the value. So batch 1 students, sample A, please get ready to note down the values. Batch 1, sample A, methyl orange endpoint is 18.4 ml. Let me simulate once again for batch 2. Batch 2 students, sample B, methyl orange endpoint is 19.1 ml. Please make a note of it. So let me simulate. Click the button. Batch 3 students, sample C, methyl orange endpoint is 18.1 ml. Batch 4 students, sample D, methyl orange endpoint is 19.3 ml. And let me simulate for the last sample. Batch 5, sample E, methyl orange endpoint is 18.9 ml. Yes.
Upon noting down the value, please enter the value as shown in the tabular column. Okay. Summary of titration 2. So what we did, we took sample water. To that we added phenolphthalein indicator. Upon adding phenolphthalein indicator, color changed to pink because it is a basic solution, so it turned to pink. So now titrate with HCl solution, it again turned to colorless. So that is called phenolphthalein endpoint. Please make a note of it. To this conical flask solution, add methyl orange indicator. Upon adding methyl orange indicator, the colorless solution turns yellow. Okay. So to this, upon titrating with HCl solution, okay, we get orange color, and that is methyl orange endpoint or total alkalinity endpoint. Please make a note of it. Now calculation. So titration 1. So volume of standard sodium carbonate V1 is 20 ml. Okay, strength of sodium carbonate N1 is, so this is 0.01 normal, which is given. So this will be given in the question paper. If not given in the question, you can ask your teachers for the strength of sodium carbonate. Okay. So volume of HCl V2 is the titer value which we got. So please do the calculation using the titer value. So I have used 19.6 as my titer value. So strength of HCl N2 is V1 N1 by V2, which is nothing but, upon calculation you get this value 0.01020 normal. Okay. Titration 2, we have two parts in titration 2. One is phenolphthalein alkalinity, another one is methyl orange alkalinity calculation. Phenolphthalein alkalinity, let us see. So volume of standard HCl, standardized HCl used for phenolphthalein endpoint is V1, which is 8.2 ml, which I have taken. So you would have got some value. So accordingly, you substitute that value for calculation. Strength of HCl is the strength we got it from titration 1. We have got this value from titration 1 calculation. So make a note of it. So volume of water sample which we prepared out is 20 ml. So make a note of it. So strength of water sample for phenolphthalein alkalinity, okay, we can find it out as V1 N1 by V3. So which is nothing but 0.00418 normal. So alkalinity due to phenolphthalein alkalinity can be calculated in terms of calcium carbonate, which can be multiplied with 50, and 1000 is the multiplication factor to convert gram into milligram. So upon doing the calculation, we get 209 milligram per liter. Similar way we can calculate for methyl orange alkalinity. Let us see that. Yeah, methyl orange alkalinity M, or otherwise it is also called as total alkalinity. So volume of standard HCl, standardized HCl for methyl orange endpoint V1 is 18.9, which I have taken. So whatever value you have got, please note down that value. Again, strength of HCl is 0.0102 normal. Okay. So which is we have calculated from titration 1. Volume of sample water, again we will take 20 ml only. Okay, upon calculating the strength of water sample for total alkalinity, that is methyl orange alkalinity, it amounts to be 0.009639. okay, normal. Now alkalinity of methyl orange in terms of calcium carbonate equivalent, otherwise methyl orange alkalinity is otherwise called as total alkalinity. So the final answer what you have got is 481.95 milligram per liter is for total alkalinity. Total alkalinity present in water is 481.95 milligram. Okay. Now the calculation is not ended here. What was our aim? Our aim was to find out how much hydroxide, how much carbonate, how much bicarbonate is present in the solution. Now the calculation for that starts. So we have here two parts of calculation. Okay, one is for phenolphthalein alkalinity, another one is for methyl orange alkalinity. So here what I have done, phenolphthalein alkalinity calculation alone I have done two times, that is with 8.2 ml, and another case it is 12.9 ml. So I have got a different value, and methyl orange alkalinity I have kept it as same. Okay, for simple reason to make you understand. Okay, what we have to do here, see, note down, methyl orange alkalinity is around 482. Okay, roughly around 482 divided by 2. So what we get? 241. Yes, 241 milligram. Okay, so half of methyl orange alkalinity is 241 is greater than 209. Yes, so P is less than half of M. So we have to find the relationship between P and M. So divide M by 2 and find out which is greater. So P is less than half of M. Here you see, here again I have 241 and here I have a different value, 328, which is greater. Now P is greater than 241. So here I have the relationship as P greater than half of M. Okay. So here for methyl orange alkalinity, P is greater than half of M. So you may get two conditions, P is less than half of M or P is greater than half of M. In our lab, generally we give either of these two conditions. Either you will get a condition P is greater than half of M or P is less than half of M. Here is a tabular column to understand if you get P is less than half of M or greater than half of M, what are the ions present and how to calculate their amount. Okay, so the formula is given. So we have other conditions also. When P is equal to 0, M is greater than 0, then I have only bicarbonate. Okay, when P is equal to M, when I have only hydroxide, and when P is equal to half of M, I have only carbonate. But these conditions we generally never give in lab. We give either of the two combination of the alkalinity. So P less than half of M or P greater than half of M is the general conditions, whichever condition is coming. So first we'll go with P less than half of M. If P is less than half of M, what are the ion which causes alkalinity? We have carbonate ion and we have bicarbonate ion. So how to calculate carbonate ion alkalinity? It is 2 multiplied by phenolphthalein alkalinity. So our phenolphthalein alkalinity was 209, which is multiplied by 2, which is 418. And we know that here we have only two ions which is present. So one I have found out, and I told you methyl orange alkalinity is the total alkalinity. So you can subtract that from 418 from total alkalinity. Total is 482. So upon subtracting, I get 63.95 ppm. That is your bicarbonate alkalinity. You can go that way, or you can use this formula M minus 2p, which is also same thing. Subtracting from total alkalinity, the carbonate alkalinity, right? If P is greater than half of M, if you have got a condition P is greater than half of M, alkalinity due to hydroxide ion and alkalinity due to carbonate ion. So we have hydroxide and carbonate ion. So if you have hydroxide ion, how to calculate that? Multiplied by 2 multiplied by phenolphthalein minus M. Okay, so 2P minus M, so 2 into, so our phenolphthalein alkalinity value was 328.95 minus 481.95, which is 175.95. We can have this value. So this is your hydroxide value. As I told earlier, I know M is called total alkalinity, so I know M value. So from 481, okay, directly if I am able to subtract 175.95, I'll get 306, which is my answer. Otherwise, I can go with the formula 2 into M minus P. So subtract M minus P and multiply by 2. So that will be 306 ppm. Okay. So don't forget, total alkalinity is met.
Thank you, students. I hope so you have understood the experiment very well. Thank you. Let us meet in another experiment.